In this video, we show what clustering is and how it works with different clustering algorithms. So what is clustering? To explain, let's take a look at this scatter plot. As you may notice, data points seem to concentrate into distinct groups. To make this obvious, we show the same data, but now data points are colored. These points concentrate in different groups or clusters because their coordinates are close to each other. In this example, spatial coordinates represent two numerical features. But even with many features, the idea of closeness or similarity still applies in a higher dimensional space. Clustering refers to algorithms to uncover such clusters in unlabeled data. Data points belonging to the same cluster exhibit similar features, whereas data points from different clusters are dissimilar to each other. The identification of such clusters lead to segmentation of data points into a number of distinct groups. Since groups are identified from the data itself, as opposed to known target classes, clustering is considered as unsupervised learning. Clusters may have different shapes, sizes, and densities. Clusters may form a hierarchy. For example, cluster C is formed by merging clusters A and B. Clusters may be disjoint, touching, or overlapping. K-means clustering is perhaps the most popular clustering algorithm. It is a partitioning method dividing the data space into K distinct clusters. It starts out with randomly selected K cluster centers, and all data points are assigned to the nearest cluster centers. Then the cluster centers are recalculated as the centroids of the newly formed clusters. The data points are reassigned to the nearest cluster centers we just recalculated. This process of assigning data points to the cluster centers and recalculating the cluster centers is repeated until the cluster centers stop moving. Clusters formed by K-means clustering tend to be similar in sizes. Moreover, clusters are convex-shaped. K-means clustering is known for its sensitivity to outliers. Also, clustering results may be highly influenced by the initial choice of cluster centers. Hierarchical clustering algorithm works by iteratively connecting closest data points to form clusters. Initially, all data points are disconnected from each other. Each data point is treated as its own cluster. Then the two closest data points are connected, forming a cluster. Next, the two next closest data points or clusters are connected to form a larger cluster, and so on. The process is repeated to form progressively larger clusters and continues until all data points are connected into a single cluster. Hierarchical clustering forms a hierarchy of clusters described in a diagram known as a dendrogram. A dendrogram describes which data points or clusters are connected at what distance, starting from the individual data points at the bottom all the way to the single large cluster at the top. To obtain a cluster partition with a particular number of clusters, one can simply apply a cutoff threshold at the particular distance on the dendrogram, producing the desired number of clusters. The shape of clusters formed by hierarchical clustering depends on how the distance is calculated between clusters. In the single linkage method, the inter-cluster distance is measured by the two closest points between the two clusters. This method tends to produce well-separated clusters. On the other hand, in a complete linkage method, the distance is calculated as the farthest points between the two clusters. The resulting clusters tend to be compact in size, but not necessarily well separated. In the average linkage method, the inter-cluster distance is calculated as the distance between the centers of gravity. This approach is a compromise between the single and complete linkage methods, producing clusters that are somewhat compact and somewhat separated. DBSCAN stands for Density-Based Spatial Clustering of Applications with Noise. It is a density-based clustering method grouping dense clouds of data points into clusters. Any isolated points are not considered as part of any clusters and are treated as noises. The DBSCAN algorithm starts out by randomly selecting a starting point. If there are a sufficiently large number of points within the neighborhood around that point, then those points are considered as part of the same cluster as the starting point. The neighborhoods of the newly added points are then examined. If there are data points within these neighborhoods, then those points are also added to the cluster. This process is repeated until no more points can be added to this particular cluster. Then, another point is randomly selected as a starting point for another cluster. And the cluster formation process is repeated until no more data points are available to be assigned to clusters. Clusters of any shape can be formed by the DBSCAN algorithm. The three clustering algorithms, K-means, hierarchical clustering, and DBSCAN are available in KNIME Analytics platform as K-means, hierarchical clustering, and DBSCAN nodes, respectively. These nodes run the clustering algorithm and assign cluster labels to data points. In this video, we have shown what clustering is. Then we have shown three examples of clustering algorithms, K-means, hierarchical, and DBSCAN.